worrying and rising curve of hate attacks, the latest, a shocking attempt to attack and, in fact, successfully vandalize the home of Asaduddin Owaisi, Member of Parliament from Hyderabad, whose home was set upon by a group of right-wing vandals right in the heart of Delhi. I actually spoke to Asad Owaisi earlier, and I began by asking him, because subsequently after the attack, he tweeted saying, this is not the first time this has happened. And I began by asking him, Asad Owaisi, tell us exactly what happened during this latest attack, and you say this isn't the first time.
Yeah, this is the first incident took place in sometime in 2015 when Mr. Rajnath Singh, who happened to be my neighbor, there was only one house between my house and Mr. Rajnath Singh, then Home Minister's house. At that time also, this sort of Hindutva ideology people, in fact, barged inside my house, broke some flower pots. And at that time also, they assaulted Raju. So, and then this is the fourth incident which took place. And I had to write a letter to the parliament asking that please open a gate behind the backside of my residence. And so that was opened. But now this time it has gone further. They came with axe. As usual, destroyed my nameplate, did vandalism, and threw a lot of stones inside my home. Hmm. And the most unfortunate part is that this 70-year-old Raju, who lives there with his family, has two young grandchildren. He was assaulted. So this is a continuous thing. I had given written complaint to the Parliament Street Police Station. In fact, I remember 2 years ago or 1.5 years ago, the Delhi Police Special Cell people came and met me. And I told them, look, you stop this nonsense because, you have a right to protest. Go to Jantar Mantar, but coming over to my home, blackening my nameplate, throwing stones, uttering all nonsensical slogans. But yes, this basically, the larger point is that the whole bigotry issue of how hatred has been created in our country, it signifies that, it shows that how emboldened these people have become. These are the real radical elements in our country and who are emboldened by the present government.
No, this is the thing I want to ask you, because you've said that in your tweet as well. You blame the BJP, you blame the BJP-led government. How do you connect that, them, to these attacks?
Because this is the fourth incident which has happened at my home. And for the first time, the police happened to come maybe, half an hour late and could apprehend these people. And, the modus operandi of these people is that they come with they don't record this vandalism with a cell phone. They come with a proper camera of a TV, what NDTV or other news channel have. And a man is already standing there. And so they know for a fact that, they have to do it in this way. They wait for it to be recorded. And no action is taken, because we know what happened at Jantar Mantar. Within 24 hours, the main organizer came out. There was no, the government didn't try to stop his bail. So basically, it is unfortunate that an MP's house has been vandalized. But the fact of the matter is that this is how all these right-wing groups are operating in our country. And they have no fear of law. They don't believe in rule of law. And they are the most radicalized of all the lot, because it serves the purpose of the ruling party to create this atmosphere, to have this dog whistle politics.
Well, are you saying quite directly that, are you saying that there's communal hate speech by BJP and its leaders which is behind the attacks of the kind on your house?
Not only that, I am of the opinion that if the BJP, the ruling party, wants this nonsense to end, it can end very quickly. It can end very quickly. They are not sincere about it. They are not living up to their constitutional duty. And they are allowing all these the main elements, these are no more fringe elements, to do what they have to do. So they are part, this is a basically a division of labor within the RSS. So you have this one group who indulges in all these activities. So if the ruling party is really sincere, they want to live up to the constitutional duty, they can end this nonsense within few hours. They can take strong action, but that is not the case so far.
Even though the fact that this is your house is in a high security zone near the Prime Minister's house.
Not only that, I am the immediate neighbor of Election Commission of India. And, you know, from 1984, when my father was the MP, that same house is being continued. Right bang opposite my house is the Parliament Street Police Station. You have Jantar Mantar with 200 yards from there. Parliament is near. So it's a highly secure zone. So for me, it is, I'm not surprised that how these people are able to evade all these secure zone and come inside and do this.
But, you know, you said that there's a complicity here with the government and the BJP. It's a division of labor. But the fact is that the police have arrested some of these people. I believe 6 individuals have been arrested. You're not satisfied with that kind of action that's been taken?
No, I, you know, what action? You know, will this put an end to all this vandalism? Will this put an end to coming and breaking the nameplate, doing vandalism? I don't think so. This will happen again. And maybe next time they'll do more. They will go beyond that. So this is just like, you know, optics, basically. Optics that, oh, we have arrested, we have confined them. But what action have we taken? I am yet to see the FIR because one of these person was carrying an axe with him. Was Arms Act used in the FIR or not? Saying that we have used, so the media reports which tell me those IPC sections are very, very less.
But tell me, Mr. Rohesi, do you actually believe that these vandals were out to cause serious harm, or was this just a publicity stunt?
See, if it had happened once, I would have agreed publicity and this and that. But it keeps on happening. You know, this is the 4th such incident. It keeps on happening. So the mens rea is there. The intention is there. We don't know when a bigger action they'll do or they'll take. But they definitely come with that intention to harm anyone. And that is there. One cannot deny that because... so we don't know because see the fact is that if you don't stop these radicalized elements now, then they will definitely do something more harmful in the future.
But you know, one question which we were trying to understand from the police as well is because there's no security at your house. Why don't you have security? Is that your own choice?
No, I am one of those few MPs who do not take any security from my state government, and I don't carry a personal security guard. Neither have I. I feel that why should I have a security? You know, why should I need a security? If a member of parliament is not safe, being the neighbor of Election Commission of India, you know, having a house right in front of Parliament Street Police Station. Then it speaks volumes about what is happening about law and order. But as a politician, I've never taken a security guard with me. I don't like people.
Okay, well, there is now a video which shows that there is security at your house. Paramilitary forces appear to have been deployed outside your house. But I want to ask you a final question because these groups have been saying that Asad Owaisi makes anti-Hindu statements. Now, again, this is no justification for vandalism or carrying out acts of violence. But I do want to ask you what your take is about that, about this allegation that you also make provocative statements, anti-Hindu statements.
Well, you see, if supposedly I'm making, for argument's sake, let us accept that what they're saying is true. Go to the court, go to the police, show your proof, bring it to the media. Okay, this is what he has said. But the issue with me is that I need to get a certificate of being a person who is secular and liberal from the liberal crowd. I need to get a certificate from these elements that I am not what they say, anti this, anti that. So we are living in very unfortunate times that you have two extreme sides. And unless and until you are at you belong to one particular group, the other group is not happy with it. So that is why I don't care whether, you know, but I'll continue to do my work. And if anyone has issue, use the court, because if you indulge in this vandalism, then definitely rule of law will be finished. And then you'll be having, you know, street fights and God knows where this will take us.
All right. Well, let's see indeed how this plays out and what action, if any, is taken against those behind this attack. But Asad Owaisi, thank you so much indeed for joining us.